As of January 18th of 2026, there are currently 45 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, representing North America's tallest actively erupting volcano, can be found a mere 70 kilometers southeast of Mexico City, Popocatepetl. Popocatepetl towers to an impressive height of 5,393 meters or 17,694 feet and has been near continuously erupting since 1994, largely producing Vulcanian and sometimes Strombolian explosions. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Hawaii, not only did the Kilauea volcano produce a new lava fountaining episode, but it also produced a series of unusual earthquake swarms which could theoretically suggest the migration of magma to a new location. Meanwhile, in Alaska, the alert level of the Pavlof volcano was raised, which is the second most frequently erupting volcano since 1800 in the United States. And in what is this week's top story, the erupting Mayon volcano in the Philippines produced its highest release of sulfur dioxide gas related to the presence of shallow magma in a whopping 15 years, totaling 4,970 tons a day released on January 16th. However, this more importantly occurred at the same time that Tropical Storm Eta began dumping heavy rain on the Mayon volcano, leading Five Oaks to issue a lahar advisory for both the Mayon and Kilauea volcanoes. Both of these volcanoes have erupted ash or pyroclastic flows that were emplaced on portions of their upper edifice in the last few years, meaning these deposits are still fairly loose and easily eroded. Thus, if sufficient enough rainfall occurs in a period of time, this rainwater can mix with these sometimes still scalding hot eruptive deposits to create a potentially lethal mudflow known as a lahar. Since as much as 20 centimeters of rain might fall on Mayon, there's potential for, and not a guarantee of, lahars, some of which might be scalding hot, to be generated in these drainages. If these do occur, they will likely be confined to their drainage channels only per Five Oaks. As for the unusually high sulfur dioxide emissions, they did not occur alongside a spike in volcanic earthquakes, which is a good sign. Thus, the increase appears to represent a correlated increase in the amount of lava that is erupting, meaning soon more pyroclastic flows each day are likely to occur. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, this Monday saw a nearly 10-hour sustained period of lava fountaining occur in the southwest portion of Kilauea's summit caldera. Lava fountains reached a peak height of 250 meters or 820 feet, but strangely only occurred from its north vent. While spectacular, that 40th episode of hours-long lava fountaining Kilauea has produced since December 23, 2024 wasn't why I included in this news video. Rather, it was because of what occurred afterwards once eruptive activity paused. As multiple distinct earthquake swarms at Kilauea's summit involving a unique type of earthquake were observed. Per a direct quote from the U.S. Geological Survey, most of the earthquakes are volcano tectonic earthquakes that accompany crack opening due to magmatic pressure. Elevated seismic activity of these intensities have not been observed at the summit since the start of the eruption in December 2024. In other words, the type of earthquakes observed generally occur as magma intrudes into a new location or is given a new potential pathway to erupt into in the future, like seen before a distinct fissure erupted during Kilauea's episode 30 in 2025. Six of these earthquake storms have occurred since January 13th, and their occurrence has three potential outcomes, mainly because they are far more scattered than the swarm associated with the new episode 30 fissure. Possibility 1 is that no notable changes of Kilauea's eruptive activity occur, as magma attempted to and failed to intrude into a new location. Possibility 2 is that a new vent erupts during episode 41 in addition to the existing vents. Possibility 3 is that magma succeeds in moving down rift somewhere in the Upper East Rift Zone, ending the episodic lava fountaining episodes the volcano has been experiencing. It is anyone's guess which of these possibilities will end up happening. And in Alaska, the Pavlof volcano had its alert level raised from green to yellow on January 14th. This change was primarily triggered by the detection of and then increase in long-period earthquakes, which are triggered by fluid movement, either water or magma. Due to our past observations of Pavlov, we know that when these types of quakes are detected, the volcano can sometimes erupt not long after with little or no warning. In addition, an unusual swarm of earthquakes occurred to the southeast, which, per the Alaska Volcano Observatory, were a bit different in character than regular volcano tectonic earthquakes. That swarm ended on January 15th, and seismic activity has thereafter continually decreased. And now, here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on January 17th of 2026. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Jay Hormel, for supporting my work.